The exciting world of electronics. Perhaps the most fascinating and certainly one of the most profitable worlds known to mankind. Most people outside the field know very little about electronics. You may have some general idea from reading newspapers and magazines, but this is the space age, the day of progress through electronics. And in spite of widespread publicity, most people do not clearly understand what an electronics technician is or what he does. Let's find out. We'll start at the beginning. Obviously, electronics involves electricity, but the basic principles of electricity are used by electronics in applications far more interesting and far more challenging than the lighting and power circuits of everyday electricity. Mainly, use of the amplifiers sets electronics apart from the electrical field. An amplifier takes a very small electrical voltage, builds it up to a much larger voltage, and uses it to perform some specific action. It may turn on a guidance jet on a missile to correct its flight path, or be used to produce intense heat in a chemical process, to print results of a complicated computer operation, or from a more basic viewpoint, to operate a loudspeaker in a radio receiver. As an electronics technician, you will of course work with this type of equipment. Working with you will be two other groups of people who are not technicians. They are the electronics engineers and electronics mechanics. And you will understand your position better if I explain what they do. An electronics engineer has usually completed 4 to 6 years in a university to obtain an electrical engineering degree. He has years of training in the highest of mathematics and theoretical information, but his practical knowledge is limited, and he does only theoretical work. He thinks about new applications of electronics techniques, and he designs circuits. He has neither the training nor the inclination to put his ideas into effect. He relies upon the technician, who will be you, to perform the practical applications associated with his projects. An electronics mechanic does actual work on the equipment. He knows how to adjust, repair, and control the mechanisms and the machinery that may be used in connection with complex electronic systems. While an electronics mechanic is skilled in a limited way, he does not have a thorough knowledge of electronics theory. Therefore, he lacks the complete qualifications you'll have as an electronics technician. With the limits in his knowledge, go limits in opportunity. Not so with the electronics technician. Your training, knowledge, and experience encompass parts of both other categories. For example, you'll have very thorough theoretical knowledge in electronics, but instead of analyzing a circuit from a mathematical viewpoint like an engineer, you'll be more concerned with what is happening within the circuit, electrically and electronically, not mathematically. In addition, you will have the same practicality as the electronics mechanic to do actual work on the equipment. But you'll have a much broader background in the field. You'll know how the circuits work, understand electronics principles, and therefore be qualified for unlimited opportunities. Sometimes you will construct electronic equipment designed by the engineer and test it thoroughly to see how nearly it does its job. In most instances, you'll report these results to the engineer. And since few circuits live up to original design expectations, this is often a beginning of a joint research project where you work closely with the engineer on modification and development until the circuit eventually performs its prescribed task. Another important function of the technician is troubleshooting. Even after newly designed electronic units have been built on a production line, they must again be tested by a technician. If this testing indicates trouble, it'll be your responsibility to correct it. Other troubleshooting includes working on important government and industrial equipment already in use. For example, if a computer employing hundreds or even thousands of electronics amplifiers is not operating properly, it'll be up to you to analyze the equipment and to locate and repair the defect. This is why the electronics technician has such an important part in our nation's missile program. Not only is he involved with the installation of equipment in the missile itself, the technician spends many hours checking and analyzing the operation of circuits and other equipment associated with the missile. These tests, by people like you, explain the ongoing effort to produce superior performance of today's missiles. The electronics technician also plays a key role in automation. Industry operations that once required thousands of people are often done by a single individual through electronics. Industrial automation is indeed expanding at a very rapid rate, even amazing rate. Since it is impossible to stop automation, it is truly a wise person who joins it by becoming an electronics technician. You will be entering one of the most forward movements that man has ever known. The facts are indisputable. Electronics already plays a vital part in our national defense program, as well as business, transportation, and commerce. It is entering the home at an ever-increasing pace. Just think about the number of radios in the homes of you and your friends, and the number of television sets, the hi-fi and stereo installations, tape recorders, electronic organs, intercommunication systems, electrical ranges with radar ovens and telephones. And let's consider aviation. Men who were famous combat pilots in World War II, even Korea, would be lost in airplanes of today. Some military planes are like vast flying laboratories dependent upon electronics to stay in the air. Speeds are so fantastic that human skills cannot match them. It takes electronic equipment in the hands of a new kind of glamour boy, the electronics technician. This new breed of man holds thousands of lives in his hands every day as thousands of jetliners cover the earth at the speed of sound with electronic equipment as the ever-watching guardian. Electronics is even entering the automobile industry. Far-sighted researchers are working to develop cars in which the driver will merely dial his destination into a small computer, then sit back and relax with the electronics doing the driving safely. When you consider all the wonders of electronics, it might seem impossible to grasp the entire subject, but it isn't. Only four different types of electronics parts are used to accomplish all of these jobs. The very same parts found in a radio receiver are found in an electronics computer, in a piece of automation equipment, or in the controls of a missile complex. Do you get all this opportunity with no effort? Of course not. You must contribute real interest, genuine enthusiasm, and plenty of confidence. You'll find that this is easy because electronics is interesting. It does generate enthusiasm, and your confidence will grow as you see how quickly you're able to understand and use electronics principles. You'll train by doing, and that's the best way. In electronics, the sky is no longer the limit. Where does it all begin? Right here at Nielsen Electronics Institute in Charleston, South Carolina. Let's go in and see how and what the associate degree program in electronics might look like. We'll start out with the basics. We won't assume that you know anything about electronics. Our first course is direct current, like the power contained in a battery. First, we'll cover theory. Right after that, you'll go to a laboratory and actually make the theory come alive on your lab equipment. And of course, your instructor will be there every step of the way. Your next subject will be alternating current, the kind of electricity used in your home. Yes, theory first, and then back to the lab for application and use of electronic instruments. Everyone has heard of the transistor. Well, here's where you'll learn how they work. We also teach the IC chips here. These chips are so tiny, they'll fit through the eye of a needle. Our students take out time for extra study in the library, and with good grades, they're eligible to join the honor fraternity. To assist you, we have the Student Resource Center, where you can use our computers to study with, or if you want, to investigate other fields, or you could use it for speed reading, math improvement, or even to reinforce your electronics background. But now, let's get back to the course. These students already know the basics, and they have already built a radio from beginning to end. Now they're troubleshooting a radio transmitter system. Later on, they'll learn about radar and microwave transmitters and receivers, such as this instructor is teaching. Electronic instruments are put to use in a practical way as these students learn how to find troubles in a TV set. They also gain knowledge about real-life schematics and how to read and understand them. What device doesn't use digital electronics? It's used in clocks, video recorders, automobiles, computers, and the list goes on and on. Here is where the basics of this new entry in electronics starts. And you guessed it, the necessary lab to put it all together. But until you use it as a system, such as this microcomputer, you wouldn't fully understand its power. With all this background and electronics application, you would be ready for the real revolution in electronics, the computer. You'll learn all about the microcomputer, how it works, how to fix it. You'll write simple programs which tell you what is broken and needs repair, and you'll be able to do the work. You're probably thinking, can I afford this? We think you can. We have a financial aid officer. It's his job to help work out the details. For instance, if you were in a low-income bracket, he would build a package consisting of Pell and SEOG, which is a gift from the federal government. It could cover all of your expenses while in school, and it's free. If you're in the middle-income bracket, he might put together a package of some Pell and a guaranteed student loan at a very low interest rate. The Pell is free, and the loan doesn't need to be paid until you've graduated, and then the payments would be very small. But leave those details to us. We can work them out. Most of our students work while in school. Our special schedules will allow you to work either full or part-time, and we'll help you with getting work, as well as housing or dormitory if you need it. What's in it for me, you might ask? Well, when you've earned your associate degree in electronics technology, our placement service will assist you in getting interviews with major employers, willing to consider you for employment at above average starting salaries. If you're interested in what you've just seen, fill out the card that we gave you earlier, and we'll contact you as soon as possible to help you make these opportunities come true. Tomorrow, your future begins here at Nielsen Electronics Institute. Time passes quickly. What you do with it is your most important decision. Talk to us. We can help. The best way to learn is by doing, and that's the way we teach at Nielsen Electronics Institute.